People are abandoning this week's GT7 daily races in their droves, citing a number of different reasons for doing so. These are the three races causing all of the problems. We're going to race each of them to understand if Polyphony indeed have got this week wrong. Let's go. Welcome to daily race A. Six laps here at Sardinia Windmills. And as you can see, we're in the rally cars. Oh my word. Now, historically, rallying has been very tough on Gran Turismo 7. Allegedly, the new physics have made it a bit easier. Well, I'm not sure about that. For a few reasons, really. One, just generally, it was really difficult to control. And two, there's a few other things, but two, you had this weird catapulty thing whenever you had a jump anywhere. So we're going to find out very shortly if that is still the case. Oh, no, not too bad actually. But yeah, rallying is very much, you either love it or hate it. I don't know anybody who kind of likes it and who kind of doesn't like it. You only really have to do it in the license tests and the missions and things and the circuit experiences, which is normally what people do at the start of Gran Turismo 7. And now this thing's 2 years old. We don't often need to do it much. Plus, people spend a lot of time out of control. And there's lots and lots of contact. What's also compounding and polarizing this for people is there's no driver rating consequence in this. Now, your safety rating's nice and easy. You can get that up to S pretty quickly again if you were to lose it. But your driver rating takes a little bit more time. But here, it doesn't matter where you come because your driver rating is not going to be affected, which just adds to the polarising Marmite nature of this rally event this week. I mean, I get they want us to use the new car and the new content, and I appreciate the free content. I think maybe, for me personally, rather than eating up a daily... Are we ghosting as well? Rather than eating up a daily race, this could have potentially been a time trial. But this is Daily Race A. Welcome to Daily Race C this week. Probably one of the most controversial daily races that we've ever seen. So, the community are very, very torn on this one. In this race alone, bearing in mind it's only Tuesday when I film this, there are A-plus drivers all the way through to B-ranked drivers in this. That goes to show how many people are doing this. Normally it would all be A-plus or all be A. But yeah, we've got drivers all the way down in B for this one. So we're at the new track. Egan Norwand making its return. And we're in an old Honda Formula One car. Now you probably think that isn't too bad. This thing is on comfort softs, so it's super duper slidey. There's only 12, I should say, drivers on any particular grid, and there's only 7 laps. This means the races are much shorter than usual, especially for a daily race C, which are normally 20-minute races. These are just over 10. So in a half an hour time slot, you're going to have 20 odd minutes to wait for the next race. Now, I'm probably going to come last in this, I warn you. But this is a straight sprint. There's no weather involved. And yeah, Oh, there we go. That is only... That is the only way, I should say, of how I'm going to overtake anybody here. These cars are extremely hard to control as well. I've actually had to turn my force feedback up to 10, all the way up, because I don't know if it's a bug or if it's just the comfort softs, I don't know, but I literally could not feel anything on this wheel. It was crazy. We've never had to do that before, but we had to do it for this one. Oh, there's another car. We've been hunted down here, so there is a little bit of racing to be had, I guess. Over the first two races, Daily Race A and this one, there hasn't been much in the way of racing because of how hard the cars handle. Oh, someone's quit there. So that puts the field down to 11. Just to put that into perspective, Mario Kart on the N64 had 12 characters, 12 racers. And that was a long time ago. And here in 2024, we've got 12 again. Six minutes, 40 seconds gone, and we're already on the penultimate lap. This is a Daily Race A type length of race, this one. There's yellows ahead. Up to ninth now. As we come around the corner to start the final lap already. Leader's already finished. Again, emphasising the field spread here. But yeah, it doesn't look like we're going to come last as we come around the final corner. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn my force feedback back down. I'm going to go to Daily Race B and have a discussion about everything. Welcome to Daily Race B. I thought I'd jump behind the camera for this one, this final race, because we see this regularly. This race is very popular this week because there's nowhere else to go, with Daily Race A being Rally and Daily Race C being the one we've just looked at. Now, due to the time trial qualification system, grids are sorted by times in a separate time trial. Oh, someone's trying to go around the outside of me here. A separate time trial session. More often than not, it becomes a procession, unless there's a mistake like the one you saw me make just then, or like the one you're about to see me make here. Should have really taken that out, but we're going to let him back through, so no worries. I'm actually going to lose a second place in the process, so we're down to sixth. And there's my case in point. The only real time you're going to get any passes here, because everybody's so close, is because of mistakes or overly aggressive moves. But this gives us a good opportunity to discuss what Polyphony Digital might be trying here. Let's try and have a balanced view. It could be, you know, that they just don't care. Now, I personally don't think that that is the case. I think it's just that they're showcasing the new content. So the new or the old rally car and Iga Norwen. Now, because of the new physics as well, it could be them wanting us to explore them in a range of different events, like on dirt and on the comfort soft tyres, around the smaller track. Or the slightly more cynical might think it's because of sponsorships. Now, it could be a complete coincidence that this Daily Race C that we've got this week falls in line with the new Honda time trial competition. The cynics may also notice that we've been incentivized by 600% in prize points or prize credits for taking part in Daily Race C, because they know it might not be that good, might be quite polarizing. Now, that will be done to increase participation, I assume. So yeah, the cynics might say it's because of sponsorships. In my view, I don't think, well, part of me thinks it is, but in my view, I just don't understand why we can't have race events that are just a couple of minutes shy of the allocated time slot. So at least 15 minutes of racing for races A and B, and 25 plus minute races for C. Sometimes I and many others actually spend more time staring at that waiting screen that's going round and round and round than actually being on the track. I'd also like to see dynamic weather, or just even random weather, for every single race that happens during the day. You know, it can be static, but it'd be nice if it was just different. Same with time, you know. It would be nice if we could have a night race, a day race, or a wet race, or a dry race, or one that, if the race is long enough, allows us to transition through a few. You know, the kind of conditions that we had from the original PlayStation showcase event. I'd also like to see some meaningful mandatory pit stops stroke tyre changes that have actually been thought through. We've gotten into a sort of a habit or a rhythm of having the same tyre multipliers and mandatory pit stops, certainly in race C, every single week. But within a few races, everybody's worked out the quickest way, and I often find myself, alongside many others, racing around on ice with basically completely red tyres because it's quicker than pitting. Now, it doesn't even need to be Group 3 and Group 4 racing every time either. There's some great categories out there and great cars out there. For example, the Mazda Touring Car, that selection of road cars as well, like the BMW Supra and the Lexus. I'd also like to see, and this is probably more of a personal preference, us around the big GP tracks, like this one, but also Bathurst that we had last week, Spa, Nürburgring, Brazil, those sorts of tracks. I mean, GT7 has such potential. It's got such a large platform. It's got quite a few pennies in the bank as well, and an incredibly faithful player base. Also, considering how much people spend on wheels, I think for me there's an obligation to make sure they're usable. We've seen the issue with certainly the Fanatec wheels in Daily Race C this week. That should not be happening. Paying 300, 400, 500, up to €1,000, pounds, dollars on this sort of equipment, it's got to work. It has to work. And I just want weekly races, I think, as a headline that actually showcase the capabilities of this game. I'm not sure why we have to wait months and months at a time before every single good race, or we have to wait for the Gran Turismo World Series events, which are sadly few and far between. Now, this sparks the conversation again of, should there be daily races D, E and F? Sadly, we've got nowhere to go either, because if we're unhappy with the daily races, the custom lobbies are still missing crucial things for me that GT Sport had. There's still connection issues, and there's no way to password protect lobbies, so you can't really even organise alternative events or leagues or anything like that, which was such a crucial and important thing to communities who played GT Sport. It's just not possible anymore. Now, in conclusion, I hope this hasn't come across as just an A-plus driver having a moan-up. I just want everybody watching this to know I feel your frustrations as well. But for me, 2 years into this thing now, I'm used to this, which is sad for me to say. Now, Gran Turismo 7 is, of course, still by far my favourite game. However, as we finish this one here in the background, it's frustrating, really frustrating, as we know how good this game can be. Here's hoping we get a better set of dailies next week. I hope you enjoyed this video, guys. If you did, make sure to check out this video here. Please like it if you liked it. Make sure you're subscribed if you haven't already, and I'll catch you in the next one.